Hi guys! So for today's video, I'm going to be doing a book review on the book Burial Rites by Hannah Kent. I have to admit, before I even start like the actual review, that the setting of this book is Iceland, and I was in Iceland when I read it, so my reading experience was kind of amplified. What was crazy too is, for our Iceland trip, we basically did like a road trip around the entire country, and the day I finally decided to pick this up, because we were there for 2 weeks, I was coming back down from the northern part of the country into the south, and that's exactly where in the book it takes place. There's a kind of a map at the front that shows you the location that they're always referring to. So it was crazy because we'd be driving and then I would just look outside and be like, oh, that's what the characters are talking about. You don't have to go to Iceland though to enjoy this book. I feel bad saying enjoy because it's honestly one of the most tragic stories I've ever read. It's a historical fiction that is based off of true events, and it follows the last woman to be executed in Iceland. The time period of the book is the early 1800s, and it's really interesting how they would deal with death sentences in that time period in Iceland. They didn't really have a means of housing prisoners, so often prisoners were sent back to Denmark in this case, but in this particular trial, when Agnes has been tried for murder, instead of sending her back to Denmark because they think that would cost a lot of money, they decide that they're going to execute her in Iceland, but they don't have a means to keep her contained, so they force this Christian family of farmers, very poor family, to house her leading up to her execution date, and they all think that she's a murderer. At this time period in Iceland, when somebody is facing execution, they are given burial rites, and one of those rites is that they are allotted a priest to try to basically make them right with God and make them at peace before they're killed. So not only does the story follow Agnes, but it also follows the priest who has been assigned to her and the family that is housing her leading up to her execution. You do get multiple point of views in the book that follow the different characters, and obviously at first most people have kind of a negative impression of Agnes, as you know, they think she's a murderer. But as the story continues on, you start to learn more about Agnes and her past and her life and all the events surrounding this alleged murder that she committed. I did mention that this is historical fiction but based off of a true story, and it's actually quite sad how much of the story is true. The author in the back of the book lists a lot of information about the research she did surrounding the story, and man, it was just, it's one of those things where when you read fantasy or sci-fi or something, there's a lot of sad things that happen in those kinds of books, but you don't really think about it, but those books are still not real. They're still might be representing things that happen in real life, but there's a part of yourself that you can say, like, that's not real, that didn't happen. That's obviously not the case with this book. It is based off of a true story, and there are so many moments that you wish weren't real, that you wish were fabricated and not true because they're so tragic, but a lot of the credible sources that the author used were how she learned about those incidents. The formatting of the story is really interesting because the author took real documents from history, had them translated, and then put them at the beginning of every chapter, and some of them are incredibly bleak. For instance, the very first chapter starts off with a public notice notifying people that there will be an auction to sell the belongings of the man that supposedly Agnes murdered. This book does deal with a lot of more mature themes, and I think it's really important that if you're going to go into it, you really understand that it was a very different time period and that people's upbringings were very different, so their mindsets were very different. For example, there are some sexist themes in the book, kind of showing how women were supposed to act and what was expected of women and things like that, and some of these sexist themes do play a role in how Agnes was tried, and I think it's really important when reading something like this and seeing sometimes the female characters in the story uphold these somewhat negative expectations that we understand it was a different time period and we don't try to force our views of how the world should be on the characters. So knowing that, you do have to go in with a kind of open mind, not open to, you know, progressive thoughts, but regressive thoughts, and expect that some of the things in the story are going to be frustrating, and it's going to be frustrating how the characters act. But it was only because of the fact that they live in a completely different society in a different time. Besides there just being elements of sexism, there is also sexual content and often relationships between characters that is unhealthy and somewhat abusive. And there is also a very, very real portrayal of what the church was like back in their time. And even though early 1800s doesn't seem like that long ago, it's much more extreme than how people involved with faith act and view their beliefs now. Another element I want to bring up about the book, because it's so good and it's such a good story, but there is something in it that I think a lot of people who are very critical of writing and very critical of the rules of writing might be upset by, and that would be the head hopping. If you don't know, head hopping is when a third person portion of a story is basically told from one person's point of view. Even though it's third person, it's still very clearly from that person's eyes. And then all of a sudden, within the same section, without a page break or a chapter ending or anything, we suddenly are getting somebody else's thoughts. I also want to mention another kind of writing rule that people often frown upon, and that would be the fact that the story is both in first person and in third person. Whenever we are being told the story from Agnes's point of view, that's when it's in first person, and then when it's anybody else's, it's third person. And again, everybody has their preferences. Some people really don't like when the story has multiple types of point of views, but I wanted to mention those things that some people might view as negative, because I want to say that the story itself trumps any writing rules that might be broken. The story is so good, even though it's sometimes difficult to relate to the characters because we just don't know life the way they know life. It's still so engrossing, and it's very atmospheric, the way they describe the environment and the feelings of the cold and things like that. It's told so beautifully, especially when it's Agnes's point of view. It's kind of simplistic when it's in third person and everyone else's, but when it's in her point of view, it's so good. That's it though for my review of this book. If you guys like historical fiction, or you like tragic stories, or if you've heard of this book and you've been kind of on the fence or intrigued, just go read it. It's so good. When I finished it, I just like turned to my husband and I'm like, well, I'm gonna be sad for the rest of the day. It's definitely one of those stories that sticks with you. I finished reading it a little bit ago and I've since started reading something else, but I just still am constantly finding myself thinking of this book. If you guys are interested in reading it, let me know that in the comments section down below. And if you have read it, let me know what your thoughts were, if it impacted you the same way it did me, because I just want everybody to go out and read this. Anyway, if you guys liked the video and you liked the review, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Click the little bell icon so you get notified when I post new videos, and check out some more of my videos right over here. As a reminder, I do have a giveaway going on right now. I have the link to the video that tells you all about the rules and restrictions for the giveaway. It's super easy, so check that out. But otherwise, I hope you guys have a great week, and I'll see you later. Bye.